just the egg whites right now. Clean bowl, clean whip. We've got the sugar here. And in this bowl, I asked Jay to mix the egg yolk and the vanilla together. Okay? So we're going to start this up. But it's not going to hold the shape. It's not going to be really white. Now, it's just starting to get frothy if you want to have a look at it in here. You don't want to whip this too much. If you whip it too much, then you're not going to be able to put the sugar in successfully. Yeah. Slowly add the sugar to it. Found that these mixers, these globe mixers, whip very fast. So you've got to be very careful that you don't leave this on here. I think that when you start the eggs from the beginning until you add the sugar, it's approximately, on this machine, it's approximately 45 seconds. Approximately. You got to go by eye. Not by the actual time. You know, if you do it in this machine, it'll be different. If you have twice as much in here, it'll be different, but it doesn't take long. Okay, and then to whip it to the next stage, step two, whip until the meringue is shiny and forms a soft peak. Well, we know what shiny is. It is shiny. What is shiny?
Soft peak.
Okay, but there's another condition here. Is it soft peak? No, it's soft, but it's not peaking at all. Okay, it's still a little bit watery, runny. So from now until the time that it is soft peak, it does not take very long. You cannot walk away.
Shiny.
It's getting stiffer, but not quite soft peak. Almost. Now, if you continue to whip this too much, it'll go from being shiny to being dull and look like styrofoam almost. Oh.
Soft.
What do you think? You think it's enough? I think that it's pretty close, you know. I could go for another maybe 10 seconds, but no more. Now, for me, medium peak is when I take it out and it's going to stand up. It's going to be, you know, a little bit on the soft side. And stiff peak is going to stand up and it's not going to wave it around. So, this is as close to perfection as I can get. Okay, so what do I do next?
And sugar.
No, the sugar's in here. And by the way, Selena, and everybody else, if there was no sugar in here, you cannot whip it to look like this. It will not be shiny. It'll be kind of rough and bubbly looking. So I'm going to put this on low, and I'm just going to pour it right down the middle in between the bowl and the whisk. And I'll scrape in the excess here. Okay, stop the machine. I'm going to put it on third speed. Now the very center of the whip, I can see it's still white, so there's some egg white that's going around with it that's not whipping up. Take this off, and I'll just move it around a little bit, get the egg white that might be on the side, egg white that might be on the top. Okay, and it's not really soft peak anymore. Putting the fat from the egg yolks into it changes the consistency of it.
above 30 seconds. That must be more than 30 seconds.
It's definitely not runny, but it's not quite the soft peak we had before. Okay? Okay, now, there's different ways of incorporating flour into a sponge mixture like this. This is the way I do it. Some people say, no, don't do it that way. There's another way, but, you know, if it works, it works. That's the end of the story. So I put a little bit in, like so, maybe a third, and from the center, I come up and I turn the bowl a little bit, turn the bowl, turn it over, just very gently. Now, most of that flour is already incorporated. Another third, center of the bowl, up the side. The same movement. Whatever you do, don't start going like this, okay? It's minimal amount of movement, getting the dry ingredients into it as efficiently as possible without getting any lumps. Pretty much all of the flour in there. Scrape the side down a little bit, bottom. I don't see any flour. Here's one way of doing this. Not everybody likes this method, but it frees up one hand. So with this size mix and with this size bag, you can get half of the mix in the bag.
Notice he's interlocking them to give them room to spread, right?
Okay, these are for the 8-inch rounds. So I start in the middle. Remember, the actual ink is on the other side.
Can you talk a little bit about the way you're piping in terms of the height of where the tip is?
Oh yeah, to the notice pan? I'm off of the pan, I'm not touching the paper, and I'm about the thickness, a little bit more than the thickness of the tip. And it's just falling. And when you're doing this, try and do it quickly and smoothly. I like to think it's kind of like, you know, when you're riding a bike or skating, you've got this fluid motion back and forth. It's just like that. It's easy. So flip this up, side down like this, and carefully pull the paper back. Don't just rip it off. Tomorrow, these will come off very easily, because it dries out a little bit.
Oh, you mean you can maybe until tomorrow?
It's easy to peel off the next day, yeah, because they dry out in the air. They're so thin.